Welcome to Institute of Quality and Reliability. Hi, this is Hemant. In this video, we will introduce concepts of fractional factorial design, confounding, and resolution course of designs. We recommend that viewers should watch our previous four videos on design of experiments before watching this video. When we run trials with each possible treatment, it is a full factorial experiment. In the figure shown of the cube, there are three factors and each is at two levels, and therefore this has got 2 to the power 3, that is total 8 runs, as you can see. The number of runs in full factorial designs increases by geometric proportion with ratio of number of levels of each factor. In case of two level designs, number of runs double with every additional factor. In three factor designs, the geometric ratio is 3, and with each additional factor, the number of runs treble. Fortunately, statisticians have created efficient designs to reduce the number of runs. The philosophy of fractional factorial designs is less testing and more learning, or test less and learn more. So statisticians have designed fractional factorial experiments to reduce number of runs or trials. Only selected treatment combinations are tried instead of all combinations. Consider a full factorial design with three factors and each factor being at two levels. We can call this 2 raised to 3 or 2 to the power 3 design with 8 total runs. Create a design in Microsoft Excel in coded units. Also add columns of interactions AB, BC, AC and ABC by algebraic multiplication of the signs in columns A, B and C. Let us now create a half fractional design with only 4 runs from this design. Experimenters have found that higher order interactions of 3 and more factors tend to be small and therefore can be often ignored. Thus, we decide to omit 3 factor interaction, that is ABC interaction, here. Therefore, we select only those rows with ABC is equal to plus 1. We want to omit ABC interaction as it is expected to be small. Therefore, we will use only those rows with ABC is equal to plus 1, which are marked red in the table, and exclude rows with ABC is equal to minus 1. So we will exclude these 4 rows with ABC is equal to minus 1, shown in red. So we omit these 4 rows with ABC is equal to minus 1. We now get a half fraction of the original 2 to the power 3 design. ABC is equal to plus 1 is the identity of the design of these 4 runs, and we can call this as 2 raised to 3 minus 1, or half fraction of the 2 raised to 3 design. These 4 runs with ABC is equal to plus 1 can be represented on the cube as shown below. First row, A is at high level and B and C are at low level. Second row, B is at high level and A and C are at low levels. Third row, C is at high level and A and B are at low level. And fourth row, all A, B and C are at high levels. So these are shown by the 4 points on the cube. The remaining 4 points we are not going to run in this half fractional design. We have reduced the number of runs from 8 to 4 while creating the fractional factorial design of 4 total runs. But what has happened in the process? Now look at the table and observe whether any of the columns have the same sign sequence. Are you ready? What did you observe? Did you notice that columns C and AB have identical sign sequence? Also, columns B and AC have identical sign sequence, and columns A and BC also have identical sign sequence. Let us now understand the consequence of same sign sequence. For example, when columns C and AB have same sign sequence, the calculation of effect also would be identical, as effect is calculated as difference between average response at high level and low level of the factor. Thus, we will be unable to distinguish between effect of C and AB. This means effects of C and AB are confounded, and C and AB are called aliases. Similarly, we will be unable to distinguish between effect of B and AC, as the sign sequence is identical in these two columns. Thus, effect of B and AC are also confounded. And with the same logic, effects of A and BC are also confounded. A video should further clarify concept of confounding. Consider design matrix of three-factor two-level full factorial design. In Excel, select only those runs where ABC is equal to plus 1. Use the Excel filtering command. This gives us the half fraction of the full factorial design, and it can be denoted as 2 to the power 3 minus 1 or 2 to the power 3 divided by 2, because that equals 4, but to show that there are 3 factors, it is 2 to the power 3 minus 1. In the design matrix, observe that columns C and AB have the same sign sequence, and therefore these effects are confounded. C and AB are also called aliases. Similarly, columns B and AC have the same sign sequence, and therefore these effects are also confounded. B and AC are therefore aliases. Finally, effects A and effects BC also have the same sign sequence, and therefore these effects are also confounded, and A and BC are therefore called aliases. Now let us see the concept of resolution of an experiment. Based on the extent of confounding, experiments are denoted by their resolution codes. Resolution of a design indicates its power and ability to separately estimate effects of factors and interactions. In general, the resolution of a design is one more than the smallest order interaction that some main effect is confounded with. Therefore, if some main effects are aliased or confounded with four-factor or four-level interactions, the resolution of the experiment would be 4 plus 1, that is equal to 5. If some main effects are confounded with two-factor interactions, the resolution would be 2 plus 1, and that is equal to 3. Resolution 2 designs do not exist, as it will imply confounding of main effects. It is customary to write the resolution codes in Roman numbers. Resolution 3, 4, and 5 designs are popular. Simplest way to understand resolution is to use our fingers. Number of fingers represent the resolution of the design. For example, resolution 3 design is represented with 3 fingers. A single finger represents main effects, and 2 fingers represent two-factor interactions. These are confounded or aliased in a resolution 3 design. Thus, resolution is 2 plus 1, that is equal to 3. Resolution 3 designs are used for screening out insignificant factors when number of factors in an experiment is large, typically more than 5. Now let us look at resolution 4 design. Resolution 4 design is represented with 4 fingers of hand. Out of this, you can have a combination of 2 and 2 fingers, and 2 fingers represent two-factor interactions. Thus, some two-factor interactions are aliased with some other two-factor interactions. And the other possible combination is 1 and 3. And 3 fingers now represent 3-factor interactions and 1 finger represents the main effects. Thus, some 3-factor interactions are aligned with main effects. Thus, the resolution code is 3 plus 1 that is equal to 4. Let us look at resolution 5 designs. We can represent this with 5 fingers of hand. So, you can have a combination of 1 and 4. That means main effects, that is one finger represents main effects, are confounded with 4-factor interactions, and the other possible combination is 3 and 2, and that means 2-factor interactions are confounded with 3-factor interactions. Now let us summarize resolution 5 designs, meaning 2-factor interactions are aliased with 3-factor interactions and main effects are aliased with 4-factor interactions. However, no main effects or 2-factor interactions are aligned with any other main effects or 2-factor interactions. Application: characterization designs where we are interested in 2-factor interactions and want to develop a regression model. Resolution 4 designs, meaning no main effects are aligned with any other main effects or 2-factor interactions, but some 2-factor interactions are aligned with other 2-factor interactions and main effects are aligned with 3-factor interactions. What is the application? Limited applications when we know which of the factors are likely to have interactions. And resolution 3 designs, main effects are aligned with 2-factor interactions. Application: screening designs where we wish to eliminate insignificant factors out of many other factors. Now let us see how to select designs based on the resolution codes. The following table shows number of runs in various designs along with their resolution codes. The top row shows number of factors and the left column shows the number of runs. These designs are known as classical designs. Designs of resolution code 5 and higher are shown in green color. Resolution code 3 designs are shown in red color and resolution 4 designs are shown in yellow color. For example, if a team has shortlisted 9 factors, a screening design of resolution 3 will have 16 runs. In this video, we have introduced concepts of fractional factorial designs, confounding and resolution codes of designs. We have also seen how to select designs based on their resolution codes. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you found it worth watching. Please subscribe to Institute of Quality and Reliability channel if you want to watch more videos on reliability engineering, Six Sigma and statistical quality control. Click on the subscribe and notify buttons on YouTube channel.